Simple truth. I bought $1.50 worth of small red potatoes, took them home, boiled them in their jackets, and ate them for dinner with a little butter and salt. Then I walked through the dried fields on the edge of town. In middle June, the light hung on in the dark furrows at my feet. And in the mountain oaks overhead, the birds were gathering for the night, the jays and mockers squawking back and forth, the finches still darting into the dusty light. The woman who sold me the potatoes was from Poland. She was someone out of my childhood, in a pink spangled sweater and sunglasses, praising the perfection of all her fruits and vegetables at the roadside stand, and urging me to taste even the pale, raw sweet corn trucked all the way, she swore, from New Jersey. Eat, eat, she said. Even if you don't, I'll say you did. Some things you know all your life. They're so simple and true, they must be said without elegance, meter, and rhyme. They must be laid on the table, beside the salt shaker, the glass of water, the absence of light gathering in the shadows of picture frames. They must be naked and alone. They must stand for themselves. My friend Henry and I arrived at this together in 1965, before I went away, before he began to kill himself, and the two of us to betray our love. Can you taste what I'm saying? It is onions or potatoes, a pinch of simple salt, the wealth of melting butter. It is obvious. It stays in the back of your throat like a truth you never uttered, because the time was always wrong. It stays there for the rest of your life, unspoken, made of that dirt we call earth, the metal we call salt, in a form we have no words for, and you live on it.